Welcome to Diligent Techies. Few days ago, I posted this FICO real-time ticket. For this, we are going to see the solution today. To know more about the issue, please watch this video, because I am not going to repeat what is the issue here. So now this issue is relating to vendor master. Vendor master, there could be three possible scenarios in vendor master. Means you can understand this issue in three different ways. I would like to clarify before proceeding. See, there may be DL control option also there, but my issue is not the concept of DL control concept. What will happen in DL control means, one person will create the vendor master account and another person will check the vendor master. So here, this is called DL control. This is already available in SAP. Here we have to define sensitive fields. We are not going to, other person not going to check the complete vendor master. Only the sensitive fields defined, he will check those and he will approve the same. The coming to the second thing, this I will discuss the third one. If the user is entering wrong reconciliation GL, then system should correct automatically, means without giving any warning message, system automatically will change. For example, if you enter the X is, let us assume that X is wrong and Y is correct, system will change the GL automatically before saving to Y. So that is also not my concept. Here we are not going to change automatically without giving any intimation to the user. So our focus is on only controlling at the source. For example, if you are going for this option, for small things, we should not use dual control. If anything can be controlled at the source, it's better to control at the source only rather than wasting the time of other persons. You can achieve without further checking with the help of our today's solution. So now another possible way, this is my issue is based on this one. When entering the wrong reconciliation while creating the vendor master, if user did any mistake regarding the based on vendor group, so we have local vendor group, foreign vendor group, so like this FI vendors. If you have different reconciliation account, if user is making mistakes while entering the reconciliation GL, then we want to throw one error message informing the user the GL entered by you is not correct, please use the correct GL with reference to this vendor group. If you like my video, don't forget to subscribe and share. If you have any comments, like any suggestions or comments, or if you have any real-time issues you want me to post on my channel, just you can send the same. If you have any issues, you can please drop those issues to Diligent Techies or sap.rashid@yahoo.com. This is my mail ID. If any company is looking for any support or implementation, then they can also approach us. We have a good consultant, good team of consultant. So now let us come to our main discussion. So now if you are expecting the solution for this one, my issue is not based on DL control, because I don't want to waste the time of others. When things can be controlled at the source, why should we waste the time of others for checking the small things? If the user, this one, this is also not our objective here. In this case, system won't give any warning message. It will change automatically. The solution for this one is different, and we are going to discuss on only this one. To know in detail, just please watch this video. Now coming to the solution side, go to the T code XK01 from where you create the vendor master. This is the T code. We will create the vendor master. So now the solution for this problem is to implement the user exit. Finding the user exit for this T code already explained in previous video. I will quickly show you how to find the user exit. Go to SE93, input your T code here, display, note down this package FBK, go to SMOD, here enter FBK, hit enter. So system is showing two user exits, one for vendor master. Click on this one, display, go to components. See, this is another name for this user exit is the functional module exit, but generally we call this as user exit only. So double click on this one. In this user exit, SAP already give one include. Include means here Z include this is. The expect means the user requirement as well while creating this one functional module. So they give the scope for writing customer own code Z include. If the customer has any requirement, they can go and they can write their own logic here for validating the vendor master. So now how to implement this user exit, I explained in detail step by step in this video, SAP FICO real-time ticket one solution. So please watch this video to know the steps how to implement the exit, because we are going to focus only on the core part. We are not going to discuss the same thing again in this video. So now coming to the solution, I will create one vendor. I entered, if you observe, while entering this data XK01, I took 8803. This is my vendor group. Here if you press F4, here we have 3 GL accounts. But with this 8803 vendor group, the valid one is first one only. If I am entering this one, if I am saving this, see, I can be able to create the vendor. Subsequently, what happens without identifying this mistake, if you start posting the entries, all the entries will get reflected in the wrong GL, wrong reconciliation GL. Trading entries will reflect in non-trading, non-trading will get reflected in trading. So that leads to the wrong picture actually in AP. For aging also, it will give wrong information. Coming to our issue, this is user exit. Go to the change mode. If you don't know how to write the logic, watch the first video, then come here, put the breakpoint here, breakpoint, activate. Now create another vendor. Here what I will do, I will enter the same wrong reconciliation GL just only to get some information, to means gather the relevant information for writing the logic. For vendor master, there are two important tables, LFA1 and LFB1. LFA1 table stores the general data. This stores the company code data. So now whatever the information like user group, the user group entered by you, 8803 will get saved in this one. The GL entered by you, this is company code specific. In one company code, it could be 100, 500. In another, maybe it will be different. So this will get saved in this data. So now after means reaching this breakpoint, click on the local. Here in this user exit, this is the exit. How to identify the exit? If it is an user exit, always exit underscore is the prefix. You remember this one. So now here we have two tables, I underscore LFA1 and I underscore LFB1. What I am trying to do here, why I am here means to write the logic, first you need to understand in the runtime where I am getting this information, in which field and which structure. See, this is the information I entered, land1 and name1 GL2. This is the structure name, I underscore LFA1. This is the structure, not the table. Don't confuse between the structure and the table. See here, under this structure name, I underscore LFA1, KTOKK, I am getting this field. So note down this one, where exactly you are getting this information. That is the first step. Vendor group, we are getting in this field, I underscore LFA1, KTOKK. This is the field where we are getting this information. Click on this desktop one, go to LFB1. So note down the same, where you are getting the runtime. This is the structure name, I underscore LFB1. AKYNT is the field where you are getting this GL information. But at the here, note down this one as well. This is in internal format. Internal format means here you can see leading zeros. So now same I already noted down here. This is the relevant field. So based on these two fields, we are going to write our logic. That is the concept here. So now go back to your, you can save this information to quit from this debugging. Just to press continue. Vendor created successfully. These are for testing only. Now we will go to our user exit. What we will do, we will write our logic there. The logic will be like this. Case is purely, this is above terminology, no need to worry. Case, when in this field, in this structure and in this field, I am making it dynamic. Dynamic means not dynamic. If you are using the case means, in the real time you can have more than one group, like local vendors, foreign vendors, or maybe different type FI vendors. You can have many different types of vendors. So for writing the logic for all, I am taking the case. If you are using this case, you can write with the help of when condition, you can write a number of logics here. When the structure, in this structure, in this field, when I am getting value 8803, when I am getting value 8803. So end case is already there. When I am getting value 8803. Likewise, if you have another group, you can write when, like this, 8804, 8056. That is the reason I took case. When I am getting value, this one, check the value in GL field. I'm checking the logic here. When this condition is satisfied, in this structure, in this field, when I am getting this value, if the field value, this structure and this field value not equal to this GL, not equal to allowed GL. So if I am entering 501. So then obviously this condition will get failed. Then message with allowed reconciliation GL account with 8803 vendor group is 100 500 only. Just this message I want to give. I want to throw this error message if user is making any mistakes, so that he can correct this one. This is the condition. Hope you understand this logic, how I am writing logic. First, when this structure, this field, when I am getting the value, check the value, whatever the value we are getting under this structure and this field equal to this one or not. If not, then throw this error message. If equal to this value, system will not execute this line item. Hope you understand. Now go to vendor again, GL3, enter 100 501. The allowed one is with this one, correct one is this one, 100 500, correct one, correct GL. So now I am taking the wrong GL. Save. I put the breakpoint here, so that is the reason we are getting into the debugging. We will see in the debugging also. Press F5, double click on this one. See, the value of this field is 8803. That means this condition will be when 8803. Okay, double click on this one. The value of this field is 501. The value of this field not equal to this one, then cursor position from here, it will jump to here. So it is throwing the error message. It is working perfectly. So what we will do, we will change this to correct one. Then again we will test. Go back. Change this to correct one and save the GL. We will see. Press F5. See the value is here. Press F5. Now observe the cursor position. If this condition is not equal to zero, satisfied, not satisfied, then cursor automatically jump to the end functional module. See, end function. That means it is working perfectly. Now to come out of this debugging, press F8 or continue. See, I can be able to create the vendor successfully. Hope you understand the concept of this user exit and how to write the logic. If you like this, please don't forget to share this video and my channel to the needy friends, those who are looking for the job and they don't know user exits and BT also there. If you see properly, I explained in three cases, three different scenarios. You can claim all those things in your interview if you prepare well notes from your side. If any company is looking for any consulting services, they can contact me at this mail ID. They can drop their mail sap.rashid@yahoo.com. Thank you very much.